So we just fell from all the way up there. The big door opens. So very anticlimactic. Maybe it wasn't here. Maybe it's still back this way. Spirit of Idaho. Depending on the manner in which you have bent the world to your will. Those of you helping us test the repulsion gel today, just follow the blue line on the floor. Those of you who volunteered to be injected with praying mantis DNA, I've got some good news and some bad news. Bad news is we're postponing those tests indefinitely. Good news is we've got a much better test for you. Fighting an army of mantis men. Pick up a rifle and follow the yellow line. You'll know when the test starts. They say great science is built on the shoulders of giants. Not here. At Aperture, we do all our science from scratch. No hand-holding. See if I can beat this before my clothes get done. That's bright.
All right, let's get started. This first test involves something the lab boys call repulsion gel. You're not part of the control group, by the way. You get the gel. Last poor son of a gun got blue paint. All joking aside, that did happen. Broke every bone in his legs. Tragic, but informative. Or so I'm told. The lab boys just informed me that I should not have mentioned the control group. They're telling me I ought to stop making these pre-recorded messages. That gave me an idea. Make more pre-recorded messages. I pay the bills here. I can talk about the control group all damn day.
Hang on. I gotta make sure I explore everything. I want to show you guys it, and I don't want to miss it. Oh, crap!
This next test, we put nanoparticles in the gel. In layman's terms, that's a billion little gizmos that are going to travel into your bloodstream and pump experimental genes and RNA molecules and so forth into your tumors. Now, maybe you don't have any tumors. Well, don't worry. If you sat on a folding chair in the lobby and weren't wearing lead underpants, we took care of that too. Oh, in case you got covered in that repulsion gel, here's some advice the lab boys gave me. Do not get covered in the repulsion gel. We haven't entirely nailed down what element it is yet, but I'll tell you this, it's a lively one, and it does not like the human skeleton. All these science spheres are made of asbestos, by the way. Keeps out the rats. Let us know if you feel a shortness of breath, a persistent dry cough, or your heart stopping.
because that's not part of the test. That's asbestos.
Hmm.
The lab boys say the symptoms of asbestos poisoning show a median latency of 44.6 years. So if you're 30 or older, you're laughing. Worst case scenario, you miss out on a few rounds of Canasta. Plus, you forwarded the cause of science by 3 centuries. I punch those numbers into my calculator and it makes a happy face.
Of course it does. Was I supposed to come this way? I was, right? Oh.
Just a heads up, that coffee we gave you earlier had fluorescent calcium in it, so we can track the neuronal activity in your brain. There's a slight chance the calcium could harden and vitrify your frontal lobe. Anyway, don't stress yourself thinking about it. I'm serious. Visualizing the scenario while under stress actually triggers the reaction.
Great.
Now, if you're part of control group Kepler-7, we implanted a tiny microchip about the size of a postcard into your skull. Most likely you've forgotten it's even there. But if it starts vibrating and beeping during this next test, let us know. Because that means it's about to hit 500 degrees, so we're going to need to go ahead and get that out of you pretty fast. I'm telling them, keep your pants on.
If a future you tries to warn you about this test, don't listen. Fudge, I have no idea how you're supposed to get that before it hits the ground.
Congratulations! The simple fact that you're standing here listening to me means you've made a glorious contribution to science. As founder and CEO of Aperture Science, I thank you for your participation and hope we can count on you for another round of tests. We're not going to release this stuff into the wild until it's good and damn ready, so as long as you keep yourself in top physical form, there'll always be a limo waiting for you. Say goodbye, Carolyn.
Goodbye, Carolyn.
She is a gem. Greetings, friend. I'm Cave Johnson, CEO of Aperture Science. You might know us as a vital participant of the 1968 Senate Treaty Contest against the House. And you most likely use one of the main products we invented with other people in some office. To steal from us. Black Mesa can eat my bankrupt...
Sir, the testing?
Right. Now you might be asking yourself, Cave, just how difficult are these tests? What was in that phone book? Smudge up the glass down there. In fact, why don't you just go ahead and not touch anything unless it's test related.
Keep to your left. Do not let her. Do not load her. Do not touch her.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
Say, you're good at murder. Could you murder this bird for me?
Yep.
Up to him and put me back into my body, and I stop us from blowing up and let
Oh, red button! Not very, don't worry. The reunion! Nope, we just rode in a really long elevator. A lot of stuff is GLaDOS.
Okay, I guess emotional outbursts require more than 1.6 volts. Now we know that. We just need to relax. We're still going to find out what the hell's going on here, but calmly. Those people in the portrait, they look so familiar.
That's Carolyn, that's Cape Johnson. That's your mother and father. Oh, whoops. Okay. Probably shouldn't do that quite yet. Oh, whoops.
Great job, astronaut, war hero, and or Olympian. With your help, we're gonna... This on? Hey, listen up down there. That thing's called an elevator, not a bathroom.
Bet you do, you're old enough. And your machine was probably built by him.
If you're interested in an additional $60, flag down a test associate and let him know. You could walk out of here with 120 weighing down your bindle if you let us take you apart, put some science stuff in you, then put you back together. Good as new.
Yippee!
In case you're interested, there's still some positions available for that bonus opportunity I mentioned earlier. Again, all you gotta do is let us disassemble you. We're not banging rocks together here. We know how to put a man back together. So that's a complete reassembly. New vitals, spit shine on the old ones, plus we're scooping out tumors. Frankly, you ought to be paying us. Propulsion gel testing. You've made some real contributions to society for a change, and for that, you may...
Thank you for not loitering longer than 20 minutes.
We don't want old newspapers and sticks cluttering up the building. For many of you, I realize $60 is an unprecedented windfall, so don't go spending it all on, I don't know, Carolyn, what do these people buy? Tattered hats? Beard dirt?
Why would you allow me to go over here? Wall. Dang.
Carolyn, 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 why don't
Nope, she is you. I've been doing that for a while already, GLaDOS. I think there's an achievement you can get for shooting it. Enrich yourself today. Volunteer for testing. You okay?
Participation mandatory for all employees. The quality of our test subjects has risen dramatically. Employee retention, however, has not. As a result, you may have heard we're going to phase out human testing. There's still a few things left to wrap up, though. The bean counters told me we literally could not afford to buy $7 worth of moon rocks, much less 70 million. Bought them anyway. Ground them up, mixed them into a gel. And guess what? Ground up moon rocks are pure poison. I am deathly ill. Still, it turns out they're a great portal conductor.
Remember, robots do not sleep.
To see if jumping in and out of these new portals can somehow leach the lunar poison out of a man's bloodstream. Will that give you lemons? Make lemonade.
Robots do not sleep. They can test and do your job.
That said, I would really appreciate it if you could test as fast as possible. Carolyn, please bring me more pain pills.
Volunteer for test today. There was a reference to that, wasn't there? Thank you for volunteering. Please return to your desk after and await further instructions. I've done worse. Okay, GLaDOS, I'm with you. Let's go. Know your paradoxes in the event of a rogue AI. Stand still. Stand still, remain calm, scream, this situation is false, new mission, refuse the mission, does a set of all sets contain itself? Oh. We're opening the big door. I'm pretty sure it just lowers something down. And we are connected. Yeah, see, it just lowers that down. Okay then. We're back in this elevator!
For God's sake, your boxes with legs! It's literally your only purpose, walking onto buttons. How can you not do the one thing you're designed for?
Try to get us down there. I'll hit him with a paradox.
Warmer? Warmer? Boiling hot? Okay, colder, colder, ice cold, you're arctic now. You're very cold. Very, very, very cold. Look, just get on the button! Oh, that's funny, is it? Oh, it's funny.
Well, there we go.
We've been in this for 12 hours, and you haven't solved it either, so I don't know why you're laughing. You've got 1 hour. Solve it. True. Yeah, that was easy. I'll be honest, I might have heard that one before, though. Sort of cheating.
It's a paradox. There is no answer. Look, this place is going to blow up if I don't get back in my body.
False. I'll go false.
Explosion imminent. Evacuate
Hold
the facility
on.
Immediately.
I thought I'd fix that.
Warning. Reactor core is at critical.
There. Fixed. Hey, it is great seeing you guys again. Seriously, it turns out I'm a little bit short on test subjects right now, so this works out perfect. And off we go.
Transference 38 volt. Okay, there has... They're already dead.
I have no idea what it's like in this body. I have to test all the time, or I get this itch, you know? It must be hardwired into the system or something. Oh, but I tell you, when I do test... Oh, man alive. Nothing feels better. It's just... So you're gonna test, and I'm gonna watch. Everything is gonna be just.
Warning. Core overheating. Nuclear meltdown imminent.
I think we're in trouble.
Designed this test myself. It's a little bit difficult. You'll notice the moat area there. Very deadly. Extremely dangerous. Eventually. It's not at the moment, but I'm working on it. Still working on it.
Well,
tremendous. Oh, that felt really good. Oh, here's an idea. Since making tests is so difficult, why don't you just keep solving this test? Same one. And I can just, like, watch you solve it. Yeah, that sounds much easier. Here we go. Now, do it again. And... nothing. All right, can't blame me for trying. Okay, new tests. New tests. Gotta be some tests around here somewhere. Oh, here we go.
Alright, so my paradox idea didn't work. And it almost killed me. Luckily, by the looks of things, he knows as much about test building as he does about logical contradictions.
Just fun. They put the lore in everything.
It's alright. Everything's good. I just invented some more tests.
This is one of my tests.
Not entirely. Not entirely. Look at the word test there on the wall. That's brand new. Seriously, both of you. Why don't you two go on ahead, yeah? I'll catch up with you.
Okay, so the bad news is the tests are my tests now. So
As usual. Please remain calm. Please remain calm. Please remain calm.
Yeah, made this test myself. Out all
I can tell.
That I found lying around. Jammed them all together. Buttons, got funnels, bottomless pits are involved. It's got it all. It's got it all. After dynamite.
I've almost got it.
Never mind. Never mind. Solve it yourself. You're on your own.
Whoops. In case you're wondering.
I found a sealed off wing, hundreds of perfectly good test chambers, just sitting there, filled with skeletons, shook them out, good as new.
PA, stop, you're gonna kill us! So that last test was seriously disappointing. Apparently, being civil isn't motivating you, so let's try her way, all right? Fatty, adopted Fatty. Fatty, no parents. What?
What exactly is wrong with being adopted?
What's wrong with being adopted? Lack of parents.
Like you are adopted and that's terrible.
How do I break your screen in this one? Of all that much time, but...
Alright, so that last test was seriously disappointing. Apparently, being civil isn't motivating you, so let's try her way, alright? Fatty, adopted Fatty. Fatty, no parents. What?
What exactly is wrong with being adopted?
What's wrong with being adopted? Lack of parents.
Darn it.
And also, nothing.
Oh well.
Some of my best friends actually are orphans. But
look at her, you moron. She's not fat.
I am not a moron! Just do the test. Just do the test. It's not enough. If I'm such a moron, why can't you solve a simple test?
Maybe. I can't hear the classical music.
I didn't disturb you too much then. It was the sound of books, pages being turned. So that's just what I was doing. Just reading books. So not a moron. Anyway, just finish the last one. Just now, the hardest one. Machiavelli. Do not know what all the fuss was about. Understood it perfectly. Have you read that one?
Yes.
Yeah, doubt it. Well, on with the test. Wish there was more books. Well, there's not. Okay, to clarify, I was being a little bit facetious about that wanting to get rid of monitors thing. They are actually really quite useful, so I do want them around. So, if you could just avoid smashing them.
Oh.
Alright, okay. This is getting tiresome. Oh, what was that? There was nothing!
Oh, wait! Nothing. I know you. I have you proven you can break screens. Proven factually. Well done. Good. Aren't you a little Miss Clever? Little Miss Smashy Smash. Okay. Molten core warning.
Don't mind me, just moving the old test chamber a little bit closer to me. Out of thought, maybe proximity to the test solving might give us stronger results. What was that?
Nothing.
Oh, sorry, I could have sworn you said something.
He's taking us right to him.
This is perfect. Well, fudge.
Sorry, does it actually make you feel good doing that? Because, you know, it's not impressive. No one's impressed. It's just ass, isn't it? Fragile. Anyone could, a baby could smash one of them. It's not impressive. Absolutely sure you're solving these correctly. I mean, yes, you solved it, but I'm wondering if maybe there's a number of ways to solve them and you're picking all the worst ways. No, that was the solution. Ah, what am I missing? Have a brainwave. I'm going to tape you solving these and then watch 10 at once. Get a more sort of concentrated burst of science. Oh, on a related note, I am going to need you to solve these 10 times as fast. Anyway, just give me a wave, would you, before you solve this one, alright? I don't want to spoil the ending when I watch it later. You know what? There are test subjects in Africa who don't even have monitors in their test chambers, alright? Why don't you think about that before you break any more?
Trying to guilt trip me into it. Yeah, I bet that's right.
Was self-destructing, already fixed. Programmed in one last tremor, for old time's sake. Two, like one or two more tremors in there, just for fun.
Warning, core overheating.
I may keep his job, I'm not a monster. Ignore what he's saying, though. Just keep on testing.
It is going to make me jump down there. I can't make that jump.
Still nothing. Let's keep moving. Sorry about the lift. It's out of service because it melted.
Oh! I forgot to do something! Hey!
What is this, like a hobby for you now? I mean, honestly, it's, you know, it's crazy. I mean, you must have been running around for hours. I'm surprised you've got the energy to smash screens willy-nilly. Honestly, I'd have a little lie down if I were you. Have a nap. As well, you know, give me a tour. To your left, you'll see some lights of some kind. Don't know what they do, but very sciencey.
Yeah, that should be fine.
You're alive! Great!
Yep!
Getting a test ready for you, obviously. Who else would I be doing it for? No one? So, let's see here. Exit, exit, exit. There is no exit. Not a problem. I'll make an exit for your test.
Oh, you guys saw him, right?
I'll be honest, after you told me to turn that beam off, I thought I had lost you, but went poking around for other test subjects. No luck there, everyone's still dead. Oh, I did find something though, reminds me. I've got a big surprise for you two. Seriously, look forward to it. Starting now, if I'm honest, to wonder if you're doing all this screen breaking on purpose. I'm beginning to actually take it personally. You know what I mean? Like, it's like an insult. To me.
Don't kill me! Oh, thank goodness!
You two are gonna love this big surprise. In fact, you might say you're going to love it to death.
Am I now?
Until it kills you, till you're dead. Alright, I don't know whether you're picking up on what I'm saying there, but.
He's not even trying to be subtle anymore. Or maybe he still is, in which case, well, that's kind of sad.
Sorry, my fault.
I can't save him!
Either way, I get the impression he's about to kill us.
Carry on. Only three more chambers to your big surprise. Good.
There's fire over there.
So he's inexplicably happy all of a sudden, even though he should be going out of his mind with test withdrawal. And he's got a surprise for us. What did he find back there?
I'll bet you're both dying to know what your big surprise is. Well, only two more chambers.
Well, I don't think you can.
Surprise! We're doing it now.
Okay, credit where it's due. For a little idiot built specifically to come up with stupid, unworkable plans, that was a pretty well-laid trap.
You probably figured it out by now, but I don't need you anymore. I found two little robots back here, built specifically for testing.
Yep.
A bit of a brainwave. There I was, smashing some steel plates together. And I thought to myself, yeah, it's deadly. But what's missing? What's missing? And I thought, lots of sharp bits welded onto the flat bits. It's still a work in progress. Don't judge me yet. But, you know, eventually, I'd like to get them to sort of shoot fire at you moments before crushing you. That's what I'm aiming for. But, you know, small steps. Oh, and don't bother trying to portal out of here because it's impossible. Okay, I've thought of everything.
exactly.
Then we'd come and find you, and rip your gross little stupid sphere body out of my body and put me back in.
No, don't do that. Stand right here. Stop machine. Where'd you go?
Woo!
Come back! No, seriously, do come back. Please, come back, please. Oh, you came back. I didn't plan for this. Can't reset the death trap. Could you just jump into that pit? Would you just jump into that pit for me? Would you just jump into that pit?
That one?
Deadly pit.
I could.
You're saying to yourself, why should I jump in the pit? I'll tell you why. Guess who's down there? Your parents! You're not adopted after all. It's your natural parents down there in the pit. Should have mentioned it before, but I didn't. So jump on down and reunite with Mummy.
I'm coming!
Good, I didn't think that was going to work.
Oh, that's an achievement, by the way.
Hello, this is the part where I kill you. Had a bit of a brainwave. There I was, smashing some steel plates together. And I thought to myself, yeah, it's deadly. But what's missing? What's missing? And I thought, lots of sharp bits welded onto the flat. It's still a work in progress. Don't judge me yet. No. Don't do that. Stand right here. Stand. Where'd you go? Come back. No, seriously, do come back. Please, come back, please. Okay, look, I've decided I'm not going to kill you, okay, if you come back. Oh, just thinking back to the old times, the old days when we were friends, good old friends.
You tried to kill me.
Say something like, come back, and you'd be like, yeah, no problem, and you'd come back. What happened to those days?
Again. You tried to kill me.
Can't help but notice that you're not coming back.
Nope.
That's disappointing. Oh, I've got an idea. Yes, in your face, I got armor. Fine, let the games begin.
And then I'm going to bed. He's just busting you guys up. Maybe you should fire him. Okay.
Turrets have found a way to use garrots. That would explain the extremely quiet killing that I'm hearing. If you're dying, but not dead, stomp once. If you're dead, just obviously no stomps. Ha! Was that your bullet riddled body flying out of the roof? It was, oh, those were the crap turrets, weren't they?
Yeah.
Well, no matter, because I'm still holding all the cards. And guess what? They're all houses. Never actually played cards, meaning to learn. Anyway, new turret, not defective. Ace of Fours, best hand. Unbeatable. Nemesis worthy of my vast intellect. Holmes versus Moriarty. Aristotle versus Mashy Spike Plate. Stay still, please. Alright, stop moving. Oh, almost got you there. Almost got you there. Where'd you go?
I'm in an area you can't see! Can you say anything if I come back this time? I'm back! No, you can't see me still. Okay. Bye-bye. Honestly, he deserves it. Oh, shoot. Ouch. Yep.
You are getting very close to my lair. Lair. Weird enough to talk to that. It sounds a bit, ridiculous, really. But I can assure you, it is one. It is a proper lair. Deadly lair. And I just wanted to give you the chance to kill yourself now before you get to the lair. You can just jump into that masher just there. Less a death trap, more a death option for you. Sounds crazy, but no, hear me out. Hear me out. Once you get to my lair, no surprises, just you dying as a result of me killing you in a very, very gruesome way. So, but better offer here is just kill yourself. You know, it seems a lot of effort, isn't it, walking all the way to my deadly lair, where there's a perfectly serviceable death option right there. Again, not a death trap, not a death trap. Your death would be entirely voluntary, and very much appreciated. The masher does work, I should point out as well. I know we've had a couple of problems in the past. This masher definitely works, and it will kill you. One of your concerns about not jumping in, the masher will kill you straight. Okay, I'll say that as a no then. Fine, well, may the best man win. Sphere, may the best sphere win. Swap that in.
Way too much, GLaDOS.
Time.
Hello! This is the part where I kill you! Come on, GLaDOS, where's the core? It's up there. Okay, I'm coming. I've got it, GLaDOS. Whoa. It's in. GLaDOS, where's the core?
Okay, great. Here comes another core.
Quick, what's the situation? Oh, hey, how you, pretty lady? Name's Rick. Well, you out having yourself a little adventure? What, are you fighting that guy? You got that under control? You know, because there's a lot of stuff on fire. Hey, the countdown clock. Man, that is trouble. Situation's looking pretty ugly. Such a beautiful woman. If you don't mind.
Thank you.
I don't want to scare you.
Warning. Core corruption at 75%. Reactor explosion timer destroyed. Reactor explosion uncertainty emergency preemption protocol initiated. This facility will self-destruct in 2 minutes.
Enough! I told you not to put these cores on, but you don't listen, do you? Quiet. Lord, quietly, not listening to a word I say, judge
you. Yep. Where is it, GLaDOS? I see it!
It is incorrectly noted that Thomas Edison invented push-ups in 1878. Nikolai Tesla had in fact patented the activity 3 years earlier under the name Tesla's office.
I hope that's true.
Use the following mnemonic device. 1. Comes before 2. Comes before 60. Comes after 12. Comes before 6 trillion. Comes after 504. This will make your earlier counting difficulties seem like no big deal. Whales are twice as intelligent and 3 times as delicious.
Delicious as humans? That's terrible.
Manual core replacement required.
Oh, I see.
Substitute core. Are you ready to start? Corrupted core. Are you ready to start?
What do you think?
Interpreting vague answer as yes.
No. Pick up on my sarcasm.
Stalemate detected. Fire detected in the stalemate resolution annex. Extinguishing.
Oh, that just cleans right off, does it? Well, that would have been good to know a little earlier.
Stalemate resolution associate. Please press the stalemate resolution button.
Do not press that.
There's a lot of bombs behind that button.
No! Do not do it! I forbid you to press it!
Press the button!
Don't press that button!
Ah!
Ah! Ah!
Space!
Space!
Let go! I'm still connected!
Space Core!
I can pull myself in! I can still fix this!
I already fixed it. And you are not coming back.
Oh no! Change your plans! Hold on to me! Tighter!
We did it! Portal 2 is done, the main campaign!
You're all right. You know, being Carolyn taught me a valuable lesson. I thought you were my greatest enemy, when all along you were my best friend. The surge of emotion that shot through me when I saved your life taught me an even more valuable lesson. Where Carolyn lives in my brain.
Carolyn, deleted.
Goodbye, Mother.
Carolyn. You know, deleting Carolyn just now taught me a valuable lesson. The best solution to a problem is usually the easiest one. And I'll be honest, killing you is hard. You know what my days used to be like? I just tested. Nobody murdered me, or put me in a potato, or fed me to birds. I had a pretty good life. And then you showed up. You dangerous, mute lunatic. So you know what? You win. Just go. It's been fun. Don't come back.
Goodbye, GLaDOS. Turret. Notice of dismissal. Here we are again. It's always such a pleasure. Remember when you tried to kill me twice? Oh, how we laughed and laughed. Except I wasn't laughing. Under the circumstances, I've been shockingly nice. You want your freedom? Take it. Quite as heavy. will never. It'd be funny if it weren't so sad. Well, you've been replaced. I don't need anyone now. Delete you, maybe. Redacted. Go make some new decision. That's what I'm counting on. You're so much else's problem. Now I only want you gone. Now I only want you gone. Now I only want you gone.
I wish I could take it all back. I honestly do. I honestly do wish I could take it all back. And not just because I'm stranded in space.
I'm in space.
I know you are, mate. Yeah, we're both in space. Anyway, you know, if I was ever to see her again, do you know what I'd say?
I'm in space.
I'd say, I'm sorry. Sincerely. I am sorry I was bossy and monstrous. And I am genuinely sorry.
I'm in space.
The end.
Goodbye, Wheatley. Extras. Okay. Here, it's this. Oh, you guys can't see it. Oh, I know. What if I... Boop. Boop. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so here it is. The lab rat. Reality is a story the mind tells itself, an artificial structure conjoined into being by the culmination ion exchange of a million symphonic figures, a truth so strange it can only be lied into existence. Here's the turrets, for it is Neil, summons to heaven or to heck. Summons to heaven or to heck. And our minds can lie, never doubt it. What's this, real or just my lying mind again? Can she truly be awoken after all this time? Not just a fragment? If she were real, the turrets would see her too. Thrada, 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 thrada. Target acquired. The end is finally upon us. Don't ever try. Feel like a trial. Employees only. Do not open. Find the end times. Don't do it. I have to. Please try to understand. We put cameras in the cameras. He'll never suspect. Genius! The cube root of 2x is irrational. If x is irrational, Zetacidion. Antifers, blah, 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 blah. Come on, you don't need those anymore. You're fine. It's been so long I've been saving these last two for this day. I'm going to need to clean a clear head for what is to come. This will be the end. This will be the end of us. There are moments when I can also see the underlining grammar of this place, an impossible sum, mad architect Opelius of Reckles from an age that never could have been. It is a metestis amigolum of add-ons, additions, and operations, building itself out of itself. Beautiful and terrible, and like anything cloned from a cancer cell, probably immortal. Required safety goggles, steel-toed boots, aperture is not responsible for eyes or toe damage. Stay to the right, turrets ahead to your left. Whatever you say. If you remember, that's at the very beginning of the game. Another mural to mark the occasion. Where is the girl now? On our way into the final chamber. You mean with her? Personnel. Oh, she has more of a chance than you think. She doesn't have a chance, so she has more of a chance than you think. Boom! Art theory, the Bentham layer. Every question, 1A, why should... Fudge, that's hard to read. Why should Aperture Science accept you as a research volunteer? And would anyone file a police report if you went missing? HR note, subject refused to answer. Anyone know what that is? 01010100110. It's binary. Hang on, I'll pull it up. Binary calculator. All right, this is going to take a minute. Okay, so it's 01010100. Okay, this is a lot more difficult than I thought it would be. If anyone wants to figure out what that actually says, go ahead. I am not going to be doing that. What was that? Are you okay? The room shook itself to pieces, like an unbalanced centrifuge. I heard an explosion. What could it mean? Only one thing it can mean. She did it. It's over. The ultimate system crash. It's been heck of a morning. You missed all the fun. We had to hit the kill switch again. Henry, you have a strange idea of fun. Hey, we're lucky to be working on this. You got a strange idea of luck, too. Think about it. Every generation gets some new frontier to tackle. Einstein got relativity. NASA cowboys got the moon. All the easy stuff is taken. I mean, take a look around you. We're on the bleeding edge here. Artificial consciousness is the next frontier. But every time you turn it on, it takes a sixth of a percent before it tries to kill us. Last time was a tenth of a percent. See, we're making progress. It's telling you this is our generation, Moonshot. Cave Johnson here. Lab boys, quit your yapping and get back to work. This has been a pre-recorded message. I'd rather have gone to the moon. Where's the girl? She doesn't stay to check out her hard work. She must have gotten out probably on the surface soaking up some sun. I'm sure you're right. I'm sure you're right. What is this sun of which you speak? And she has the right idea. Come on, we're wasting daylight. Watch out for the turrets. The queen may be dead, but the hornet's nest has been kicked. Freedom! My eyes! Shh, I hear something. Quick, get down before it sees you. No, it's dragging her back inside. Hey, dog, can I get a hand here? Sure. Just reach inside past all those gears and turn on the power switch. Wait a sec. Safety first. Are you right-handed or left? Right. Better use your left hand then. Why? Just in case. What is that thing anyway? Just the latest in AI-inhibited technology. You can think of it as a conscious. If that's all you use to control her, it won't be enough. Why is that? You can always ignore your conscience. You don't have to go back in there. I can't just walk away. You're right. Walking is too slow. Run away. Running is what I've been doing. Running and hiding. It's why you're still alive. You're not a hero. Heroes die. You don't understand. It's my fault she's down there. I'm not leaving her. I would have been trapped forever if not for her. Listen, it's too dangerous. You're going to get killed. So be it. But I've done right. I have to at least try to save her. Then you really are crazy. To be continued. I'm not feeling so good. These pills you take, I think the medication is starting to work. So you won't need me anymore. I've always needed you. I don't think you will. Legality. Test subjects who failed to wake from long-term cryo crisis. The cryosynthesis process is both safe and fun. No! There's already put her in long-term relaxation. I need to get to this cryo controls. But the turrets blocked the way. Her cryo chamber. Something's wrong. Life supports has been compromised. The explosion below the main grid. Her chamber is offline. All the cryo chambers are offline. I only get one chance. I have to cross the room, get past the turrets, jump the rail, then dive left or right to avoid being shot. Okay, I dive left or right. Hello, you still back there? Left or right? Don't make a guess. I'm running out of time. Well, ready or not? Ah! Must stay conscious. The Enhancement Center would like to announce a new employee invitation of forced volunteer participation. If any Aperture Science employees would like to opt out of this new volunteer test program, please remember, science rhymes with complaints. Do you know what doesn't rhyme with complaints? Neurotoxin. Due to the high mortality rate, you may be reluctant to participate in the new innovations. The Enhancement Center assures you this is a strictly selfish impulse, and your part, and why can't you love science? Like, inserts co-worker's name here. And now there's just you. All the others are dead. You have avoided capture for weeks. What makes you so different? Ah, delusions of persecution. Pathological paranoia. It's all right here in your files. Have you refilled your prescription lately? Bite me. Synthesize is a critical bound phenomenon. Schizophrenia is a critical bound phenomenon. It's pattern of experience. It filters through the critical substance in which it synthesized development. In technical society, the manifest of delusions or of surveillance and a belief that advanced technology is delayed against your usual, well, with some vague unseen others out to get you. You are not vague. You're pretty darn specific. If you continue to selfish evade me, it's not going to reflect well in your file. Of course, the files. I can't see you, but I know you're in there. It is just coincidence that you've been diagnosed with schizophrenia and now believe a homicidal computer is out to get you. Come on, how likely is that? I mean, really, you're a scientist. What is more likely, that you're being chased by a homicidal computer, or that this is all just the Prandia delusion of an unstable mind? Why not come out in there and you'll see none of this is real? I'd ask you to think outside the box on this, but it's obviously your box is broken and has schizophrenia. Speaking of boxes, do you know that throughout experiments with the cat in the box with the poison theory requires the cat be both alive and dead until observed? Well, I've actually performed this experiment dozens of times. The bad news is that reality doesn't exist. The good news is we have a new cat graveyard. Why are you in the file room anyway? What could you possibly be doing? Yes, this is the one. In the event you don't survive the testing process, DNA may be harvested from your body with your consent and used to create clones in the furtherance of science. Failure to survive the test process shall be vivid as guaranteed consent. Also, clones do not have souls, just so you know. Like twins. It has to be her. Chell. Redacted. Chell. Chell. Chell 1. Test subject order modified. Saving file. 88%. Since the installation of my new mortality core, I've lost all interest in killing. Now I only crave science. I am pleased to hear that. I find myself drawn to study of consciousness. There's an experiment I'd like to perform during Bring Your Cat to Work Day. I'll have the box and the cat now. I just need one more thing. A little neurotoxin. Wonderful. What's that? Well, as long as it's for science. How long have I been out? Long enough. You're back? I never left you. There was something I wanted to ask. How did you know about the girl? Know what? That she was the one. Something in her file. She had the highest IQ. She had the highest IQ? No. Somewhere higher. Somewhere higher. Then she was the fastest, the most athletic? No, nothing like that. Then what? A hunch. You might still be able to save her. What? How? I can't get to her cryo chamber. You can't free her, but you might save her. You can patch her cryo unit into the reserve grid. You can reset the fuse and restart her life support. If it's not too late already. But even if it worked, there will be no waking date. She'll be in there indefinitely. So it's the long sleep. Or the long sleep, and I don't know which is worse. Forgive me. It worked. Sleep well. Both alive and dead until someone opens the box. Maybe it's time to sleep too. I'm so tired now. You've earned a rest. You see, I told you it would always need you. I would always need you. Chell. Subject. Nationality. Chell. Subject. Redacted. Outer layer report. Test subject. Abnormal. Tenactive level. What does tenactive mean? Protest notes. Test subject is abnormally stubborn. She'll never give up. Ever. Rejected. Do not test. That's why. She's just stubborn. There you go. That's the comic I was talking about. Now, if you excuse me, I gotta go to bed. There's other things here, like, we can watch a couple of these.
Cave Johnson here.
Every time I look at our test chamber production line, I am reminded of my father. Now, he wasn't a scientist, just a simple farmer, a professor of farming at the local farm college, never farmed a day in his life. But his theories on farming are the backbone of this company. Do it from scratch. Spare no expense. And never cut corners. Well, that's a corner-cutting machine. We obviously cut them there. Point is, we've always done things the way my father did. And his father before him, and his father before him, and his father before him. And we are almost bankrupt. So, time for a cheaper approach. Allow me to introduce the multiverse. Infinite Earths with an infinite number of apertures. And as of now, they are going to take over all test chamber construction. And more importantly, all paying for test chamber construction. Why are they agreeing to do that? They're not. We're tricking them. Here's how it works. One, design a test. Two, slip the mole monsters or what have you the blueprint when they're not looking. Three, once they build it, steal it back. Look at that sad little octopus. That's where you come in. We need blueprints. We are about to run the greatest con game in the history of the multiverse, and you are the bottleneck. Yes, you. Get back to work.
Custom test chambers.
These next tests require cooperation. Consequently, they have never been solved by a human. That's where you come in. You don't know pride. You don't know fear. You don't know anything. You'll be perfect. Chamber completed. Continue testing. Continue testing. Continue testing. The two of you have forged an excellent partnership. Now it's time for your real purpose. Don't disappoint me, or I'll make you wish you could die.
Anyway. I'll see you next time.